It was winter, the beginning of the northeast monsoon season in the Philippines. Our small pump boat glided over fresh swell as we headed into the unknown. The island slowly came into view with palm trees swaying gently in the breeze. As we waded ashore, inquisitive kids welcomed us to paradise. That winter, the island became our home. Our lives suddenly simplified. We watched fishermen paddle in with their catch, slept in the open on creaking bamboo floors, ate the fruits of the sea and trees, and surfed the strong, rising waves on high tide. Miles away from civilization, our joy mirrored the lives of the children who reveled in their tropical playground. One of the most enthusiastic local surfers is Cree Cree Bo. Desperate to ride the waves, he and his friends constructed boards from kolo tree wood. Over the years, they traded their wood for real surfboards donated by a group keen to develop the island. Cree Cree dreams of world championship glory, following in the footsteps of his hero, Kelly Slater. At the very least, he believes if the right sponsor would come along, he could win thousands of pesos at the Cloud Nine contest on famous Siargao Island. Cree Cree loves to surf, but recognises the need to study hard for a better future. Despite the close proximity of the waves, he always goes to school. Next year, he'll leave the island behind to attend high school on the mainland. Would island development or sponsorship really help these children? Or could it signal the end of their innocent and tranquil life? For now, Cree Cree and the Kola Boy Surfers are free to paddle out and have fun. gliding down waves without a worry in the world. Is change something to fear? Each step we take outside our normal routine is an opportunity to stumble upon something extraordinary. Embracing change brought us to this unique island where time stands still. A kind family provided a shelter, but more than that, we suddenly had a vantage point into lives so different than our own. The people lived day by day, dreaming of more, but fairly satisfied with what God had provided for them. Such an amazing sense of warmth in their rustic community of chickens and basketball. And it was this warmth that I would take with me as our winter drew to a close. As we gathered our belongings together in preparation for departure, the island gave us one final gift, a flawless afternoon of surf shared with new friends who will last forever. So what is first yoke? Well, it's when you find love in something or someone, that feeling of newness you never want to end. We discovered it over and over again on the island, in the perfect waves, along its lonely shores, and most of all, in the people there. Change would inevitably come, but it didn't matter to us. We had already had our time. We experienced the first yoke, more fun in a few weeks than many have in their whole lives. The search was not yet over. It never will be. There's always a chance that the next stop will be even better. better than the last.